are members of Seraphic Fire. For those of you who are unfamiliar with us, or perhaps are having your first experience with Seraphic Fire, we are a professional vocal ensemble based in Miami, Florida. As of this August, we turn 20 years old. This is our 20th year. The ensemble is made up of professional singers from across the nation. We're sort of an all-star choir. We bring people from as far away as across the Atlantic and I suppose Seattle or San Diego to come together to perform both new and old music. Our repertoire spans over 1,000 years of music. We have been featured soloists with ensembles like the Cleveland Orchestra. We've recorded with pop stars like Shakira. We have 16 discs, two of which have received Grammy nominations. And we serve a number of communities in the South Florida region, including Miami, Coral Gables, Fort Lauderdale, Boca Raton, and Naples, Florida. We do this as a full season. And put together really what we hope to be compelling programs that show the human voice to its fullest. We began tonight with a piece that we commissioned a number of years ago from a composer named Sidney Guillaume. Sidney was born in Port-au-Prince, Haiti. He moved to the Miami region when he was 8 years old, went to high school in Miami, went to the University of Miami for a composition degree where he actually sang with he's one of the members of this choir there, and he wrote that piece on a poetry by his father. He's now a film composer in Los Angeles. We move on to three other pieces that I think are representative of our work. The first is a neo-medieval work by Cecilia McDowell, a British composer, on the text Almo Redem Toris Mater, where she samples some of the melody from the Gregorian chant, Almo Redem Toris Mater, but weaves it together with both medieval and contemporary harmonies. From there, a piece that was arranged especially for us, it's a piece by Ingram Marshall. It started out life as a piece for four singers who sang into microphones, and the composer would manipulate them electronically in the course of the performance. We asked if we could transcribe it for our 10th anniversary, and he said no. And then we talked to him, or he allowed us to do it, and has since sanctioned and promoted the arrangement. We sing it tonight because Ingram actually died 2 months ago, and this is the first time we actually have performed since he's died. And so this is that piece is done in memory of Ingram Marshall. We finish with a piece that is a bit of a nod to our hometown of Miami, Rafael Hernandez's rumba, El Cumbanchero, in a fabulous arrangement by Wario Nex Morales Matos. So three pieces that show a little bit of what Seraphic Fire is all about.
Thank you.
And this has sort of exploded over the past 20 years. During that time, however, there has not been a university program to train people how to sing an ensemble like this. The university system is mostly concerned with both song and opera these days. And about 10 years ago, we decided that we would start a program called the Professional Choral Institute, where we would take young singers who were either in the latter part of their undergraduate degrees or the early part of their master's or doctoral degrees and work with them on the skill sets, the particular skill sets needed to sing in a small professional ensemble. We, 5 years ago, thanks to the great generosity of the Aspen Music Festival and Alan Fletcher, came and brought this this program into association with the Aspen Music Festival. And so for the past week and a half, the members of Seraphic Fire have been faculty to 28 aspiring young singers who have applied from around the country to come and learn the various things that one has to do to make a living as an ensemble singer. Those things sometimes being, we've dealt with song, we've dealt with small ensemble programs, we've dealt with a number of different languages. I think you'll notice on this program, I think we have at least 5, maybe 7 different languages on the program. But also talking about the entrepreneurship that is needed for freelance musicians. Almost every professional choir, unless you're in one of the military choirs, is a freelance ensemble these days. And so those folks have been with us for the past 10 days, and it has been a wonderful experience as we get to see the future of what our art form will be. So without further ado, please join me in welcoming Seraphic Fire, the members of the Professional Choral Institute, and Seraphic Fire's Associate Conductor and Director of the PCI program, James Bass, to the stage.
Thank you. Many of the students told me that when they arrived, they didn't think they liked it, which set me on the course to convince all of them that they would like it. And that regardless of whether you like it or not, professional ensemble world, you better act like you like it on the stage. But I think I did convince a few of them. Brahms is a composer close to my heart. My doctoral research study was on Brahms. And believe it or not, as a conductor, that's the first time I've ever had a chance to conduct all four of those as the set that Brahms intended. And I think they're quite amazing, spectacular chamber music, and I'm very proud of the singers. Congratulations. Now, additionally, we have a collaborative artist with us, Leona Chan, who came and played the Brahms so spectacularly. She's been with us all week, working with us in our rehearsals, working with us, of course, on the pieces that require keyboard accompaniment, but we're very fortunate to have her, and we want to thank Leona right now. Thank you. Our next two composers, three pieces, are newer works. One is literally brand new, and I'll talk to you about that in a second. These next two pieces are by William Averett, and they set the text for the incredible American poet, editor, scholar, Langston Hughes. And both of these melodies, these tunes, these choral works, have incredibly deep meaning, textually. And it's something that we do try to discuss in the professional world. We don't get to do very often because rehearsals are short and fast. But these pieces, written at a time in which Black Americans, especially in the Harlem Renaissance, were finding every way they could to express their creativity, their worthiness, and their beauty, like St. Hughes did it through these poems. And you'll hear some angst in both of these poems, but the second one for sure. And in a minute, you're going to meet our other set of hands for the piano. Both of these works require four hands on the keyboard. And the second one, Dreamkeeper, you'll hear the incredibly difficult perpetual motion of our collaborative artists that kind of represent the implacable opposition to freedom and acceptance. So those will be the Afro-American fragments by William Averett. And then, this year, in addition to our first time conducting program, we partnered with the composition program here at the Athens Music Festival. And Christopher Theophanides, who is running that program. And last week, we were able to take this ensemble and read three brand new compositions by choral composers and composers in general here at the Music Festival. They had submitted their scores earlier, and one of them, the fourth, was selected to be performed today on this program and will receive its world premiere. Ask the Orange by Gala Flagello is being premiered today for the first time. We're so excited she's here. We'll meet her after we do that. But right now, please help me welcome to the stage our second set of hands, Muse Lee for the William Averett Works.
Thank you.
turn and say for a moment to the students, it has been such a wonderful honor to be able to work with you on this repertoire. You are amazing musicians, and Ravi, and all you have done in the past. Participate in this art form, many of them come from disadvantaged backgrounds. It's very simple as to why. You don't need any equipment, you don't need a special instrument to use. Often the beginning ensembles that you can participate and participate throughout your life are free to start out in. So many of us started in community organizations. As a result, as people get older and look toward training programs, we need to be able to provide scholarships to people who do this. Fortunately, our Miami community, our South Florida community, has been incredibly generous and allowed us to give the most scholarship money that we have given in the history of the Professional Choral Institute to this year. I thank those of you who are in the audience, but I would like to let you know that even though this was the largest year ever, we still had students who were unable to come because of cost. Our goal with this program is that eventually all 28 spots in this program will be fellowshipped. If that's something that you feel is important, please feel free to come and talk to me afterward. Our program today, we're ending with a piece by Jaco Mantieri. This piece was written upon the sinking of the Estonia, a car ferry in which over 900 people perished in a storm. As part of the Finnish news, once a week the news is read in Latin. And so he sets that text, the Latin text, of the news of the sinking of the Estonia with the psalm text, they who go down to do work in the sea with ships. It is an incredible monument to these people who died in this incredible tragedy. And so we are honored to be able to perform it for you today. Thank you so much for being here today. So many people were part of this. So as well as you, your ears make it possible for us to sing. So thank you so much. This is the Cantu Cum Calamitatis by Jaco Mantieri.
hoc licentiam in est vitam a miserum, calamitam.